Hi. This video demonstrates how to test USB HID communication speed for target-to-host PC hardware in the loop simulation. In this example, the target will read an analog input channel 13, pin C3, and send this data with data packet ID to the host via USB HID. The host will display received data packet ID together with ADC data on a scope. First, connect FIO target to the host PC. Use a true host PC USB socket, not via USB hub for best speed. Set FIO target and USB in application programming mode. Bye. Set jumper J9 to logic high, set the program switch to the right, then, press the reset button. Test host PC to target connection using request product info command. Note. Pin C3 analog input channel 13, is connected to the potentiometer output. Open test speed HID1 target model file. Update the diagram twice or until all blocks display correct sample time. Set to auto-compile and download. Start the build process. Open test speed HID1 host model file, and update the diagram twice. Set the FIO target and run custom user program mode, bye. Set jumper J9 to logic high, set program switch to the left, then, press the reset button. Run the test speed HID1 host model file. Simulation status, count index of each packet, and output voltages from the potentiometers can be monitored for correct operation. The simulation is real-time as long as: first, count up diff is 1. Second, Simulink time step does not exceed the smallest block's sample time in the target model file. For this example, it is 10 milliseconds. Data acquisition can also be run from MATLAB command line M file. Open test speed HID1.m and run the M file. At the end of the test run, various parameters such as maximum possible data acquisition speed on the host PC is reported. Here are some useful tips. In the USB HID send block for the target, an option is available to toggle an output pin every time a data packet has been sent. This option allows a more precise simulation time step to be measured using an oscilloscope. A final note, because Simulink is running under Windows. To improve real-time performance, try closing all other applications and run only Simulink. This is the end of the video. Thanks for watching.